So Google's Gemini AI can run inside of Google Docs now and offers proofreading. So we're going to compare that to what I consider to be the standard for proofreading, which is Grammarly. So on the left is Google Docs, obviously, and on the right is Grammarly. We'll run them side by side and just talk about the differences between what they catch. These are both paid accounts, so we're kind of comparing apples to apples that way. So when you go into Docs, if you have the right paid version of Gemini, you see this kind of nondescript, let me hover over it, proofread this document button. That's what we'll, well, let's click it right now. That turns on this sidebar where you're going to see the suggestions. So we'll leave that up and then we'll come over into Grammarly and we'll start the assistant. All right, so we can do this live and see what it says. And the next thing to keep in mind is let's click on these proofreading settings and make sure all of these are on. So when I first installed this, I made this video two other times and then realized that the grammar checking wasn't on. I was wondering why it wasn't catching anything, but come in here, make sure these are all on, and they are now. And we will do our first category, which is spelling. It should get spelling right, right? Word processors have checked spelling for 30 years. So I have some commonly misspelled words here. We're going to copy these. We'll paste them in the Google Docs. I haven't done this yet, so we'll see how it goes. It should catch them all. Give it a second. So it caught the first four, and it seems to think column is okay. Maybe there's a type of column that you can spell without an N on the end. Let's check. We'll go over into Grammarly. We'll paste those same words. And it caught all of the misspellings and also column. So if you will, permit me a short side. I think just Google Docs can't spell that right, according to word.tips. The first one, and Grammarly. Let's look up. Well, apparently there is a word column. I don't know if Google Docs knows of that word, and it's thinking that I was talking about a poet or playwright, but most likely that's misspelled column. So make your own judgments here. I'm saying that Grammarly probably did this one better. All right, so we'll move on from spelling. You get the point. Both of them should be able to catch spelling errors pretty well. Unless you're talking about architecture, apparently. And let's go into the second category. So in case you're wondering, I have these in a text editor first, so I'm sure it doesn't change anything, right? So sometimes this AI will suggest something and make it better, and I don't want that to happen because the whole point of these is to see if they're corrected. So I wrote out here five sentences, and I made some obvious grammar errors in them. The first one is a list missing commas. The second one is please give me seven pennies. This is a stylistic suggestion where you should probably type out the word seven. I did pretty good on that English test. Hopefully you know that that's not good grammar. I lied down on the bed so I think that should be laid down. We'll see what it does with that. And I made a turkey. So you don't make a turkey, you cook a turkey. I'm not really sure if that's grammar or just expressing the concept correctly, but we'll see what they say. So let's paste this into Google Docs using Gemini first. We'll give it a second to think. And it pointed out a lot of things, right? So the there is just the wrong word. It's not misspelled, it's the wrong word. Missing a comma. Pretty good. Hopefully it said well. Yeah, it's suggesting well. And then lied, it said should be laid. So it caught all four of these. Interestingly, they're all in the grammar category. I was wondering if the conciseness or the wording would apply to some of these. Like I thought maybe the wording would catch I made a turkey, turn it into I cook a turkey. Let's see what Grammarly does. I have not done this yet, so we'll paste these into here. Give it a second. It caught the same there. Apples and oranges, let's just take these suggestions, yeah. So Grammarly suggesting the Oxford comma before the and, let's accept that. and let's go over and accept all the changes in Gemini. I don't think it was suggesting that. So there. So nah, that one's not right and one's not wrong, but Grammarly likes the Oxford commas. The next one, neither of them changed 7 pennies. Okay, fine. I did pretty good on that English test. Grammarly suggesting that I change the adjective. It is looking weird here though, because it didn't underline it, but we'll click on that. And there's a suggestion, did pretty well. And it caught lie down on the bed. So if neither of these are catching, I made a turkey. Maybe they're just both thinking that I made a turkey, which I don't know how I would make a turkey, but I digress. We'll delete these. We'll move on from that category. Let's go back to my text to see what else I have here. All right, so I do use Grammarly a lot, and it likes to tell me that I use active voice. This is something I would have thought of after I got out of 7th or 8th grade English class, right? But it does like to suggest it, and when I change it, it maybe makes the sentence a little bit better. So we'll test this on both platforms. So let's copy this. First, I'm going to put this into Grammarly because I think it's going to correct both of them. Yeah, the book was put on the table. It doesn't like that. It said, consider rewriting, saying who the somebody is that put the book on the table. So it didn't suggest exact wording to rewrite it. Maybe because it doesn't know who put the book on the table, but it is calling that out. And the car was driven is also being called out. Okay, let's go over to Google Docs, put those both in here and see if it wants to make those same suggestions. Now, do note that I have active voice checking turned on, but it's not catching either of those. Interesting. Let's highlight one just for kicks. The car was driven everywhere. And you can do this where you click, no, it's up here, help me write, and you can choose rephrase. Now, it didn't tell me to do that, so I would have typed that and just moved on with my life and not known that it was in passive voice. But if this is something you want to be better at, I'd use Grammarly for now. But let's do rephrase and see what it does. Every corner and road was conquered by the car's spirited journey. I have no comment on that. I'm closing that. Enough said. Discard. Maybe you would want that. I don't think I do. And for this last example, we're going to do kind of a real world example where we're going to go to my poor old website here. I was using one that's newer, but this has already been checked in Grammarly. So we're going to go to my old website. I don't update that much these days. And we're just going to copy the text from a page and paste it into Grammarly. And actually, I'll find a bit of an older, even older article. I think I have one about Adobe or not. Let's search for Excel. I haven't written about Excel in a long time. And we will look at how to double underline in the Excel mobile app. Kind of an odd topic I decided to do, but all right, we're going to, so we copied the entire web page. And this is a good real world example, right? Maybe I wanted to go back and improve this web page. And the first thing I would do is just look for errors that I wouldn't have been able to catch when I wrote it 10, 15 years ago. And so I pasted them. You have to be careful though, because you'll pick up headers and footers if you do it the way that I did. Let's delete a little bit of this so we don't get confusing recommendations. And we'll go into Docs, and you'll see it pasted differently in Docs because Docs tries to take more than just text. That's probably a nice thing about using Grammarly if you want to be distraction free. All right, that's good enough. And let's turn on and off proofreading. I don't know why, just feel like we need to do it. And right away you can tell that Grammarly is a lot more aggressive in what it's doing. So I didn't plan this. I had not looked at this. I haven't seen this webpage for probably 10 years. but it is proving to be a good high-level example without even looking at any of the individual suggestions, because Gemini has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 suggestions. And when you look at Grammarly, they just scrolls off the page. It's really making me want to go back and update this page. Honestly, maybe I'll do that when this video is done. Oh, I even said something like pared down. Did I spell that wrong? No, just hyphenated. Well, Gemini didn't say hyphenated. It's probably right that you'd hyphenate it. Anyway, I digress. Point is that these are two very different apps. You've seen several different examples that will show you which one is better for you. Do you want it to be more aggressive? Do you want it to check and find only the things that are obviously wrong? So maybe you meant to spell column C-O-L-U-M. In this next video, we're going to go through how to control the page numbering in Google Docs. If you're still using Pages in Docs, you can turn that feature off, by the way. I'll link to it right now, and I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.